Hanging out, friends. It's me, Lola. You are listening to The Smoking Prophet. The Smoking Prophet is a life advice brand designed to resource you spiritually, creatively, and socially. Our goal is to give you what it takes others years to get. And today I want to do that by giving you a simple piece of information to help you break through fear and break through your comfort zone so that you can try new things and actually get to the place that you want to get in life. So having it all together is stopping you from having it all together. Actually, having it all together is just a complete lie. Nobody has it all together. My husband and I were just talking about a very interesting thing, that everybody has some type of ugly trait, internally, externally. Everybody has something that they see that they don't want to explain, something that they deal with. And I named two as I was talking to my husband. I said, I have two ugly traits. I said, one ugly trait is my lips. Like I said, my lips are very emotive. Like they move, they're very expressive. They like to just go their own way. And I'm like, people normally, I just see like their mouths go into certain shapes. I said, but mine, like it just does what it wants to. And I said, I got it from my dad. I said, my dad's lips were very, very emotive like that. So I said, that's one of my ugly traits. I said, and then I have another one too. And so we talked about that and went on about our business. But I'm saying that to you to say that everybody has something that they need to work on. Everybody has something that they don't like about themselves. Everybody has something that they feel they could be doing better. And if you always pretend like you don't have anything that you could be doing better, it stops you from getting better. Okay, it stops you from being vulnerable around people who can help you. It stops you from saying, hey, I need some help, and getting it when you need it. It stops you from getting better. So stop pretending that you have it all together. Having it all together is a lie. At some point in life, everyone, even when they're at the top of their game, they have something that they want to work on. Okay, now let me tell you what made me think of this. I'm taking some classes so that I can get better at what I'm doing. So I'm getting some certifications and some other stuff. And in the class that I'm in, I'm around a bunch of like educators, like people that have been in the field of education for a long time, higher learning. Some of these people are at universities creating curriculums and stuff. Some of these people are at elementary schools teaching children. Some of these people are doing like complete online remote learning, and others are doing other things. But I'm around all of these people, right, that are doing this thing that I'm not really doing, right? I don't do anything like that. Education is not my background. It's not my base. I came out of the financial market. And so like, I'm just sitting here like, oh my gosh, you know, I'm excited to be doing this. But now I'm starting to feel a little low. I'm starting to feel inadequate. I'm starting to feel like I'm not enough. But I said, I'm not gonna let that stop me from getting what I need to get in this class. I'm gonna posture myself to learn fully. And me posturing myself to learn fully is me not pretending like I have it all together. I had to be honest. So sometimes on our discussion boards, I would say things like, I have no background in this. I'm not really sure what I'm talking about, but this is what I'm thinking. Or I'd say something different to let the people know that were there looking at my discussion that, hey, this is not my thing to do. And what I found is that people were so willing to help me. Man, they would say, I like your idea. Take a look at this too. Check out this research, check out this person. And I'm like, oh my gosh, it's helping me. And it was so, so great. And what I found is that when I was vulnerable, when I stopped pretending like I had it all together, the people that were doing what I want to do in the future came in and told me how to do what I wanted to do. They came in and told me what I needed. They came in and helped resource me. So that's the point that I'm making to you. When you are vulnerable, when you don't pretend like you have it all together, you position yourself to learn fully from people around you that can come and help you. Nothing we ever do is alone. Success is not earned alone. It comes through many, many hands, through many, many feet, through many, many feet, through many mouths, through many hearts, through many minds. It comes through many different people. So you gotta posture yourself to be vulnerable so that you can get the help that you need. Yes, your vulnerability won't always be welcomed. Yes, sometimes people may look at it like and think, oh, are they really ready for this position they're trying to go into? I'll tell you something. I had two situations. I ask a lot of questions, and I learned by reading this book, The Innovator's DNA, five skills of like disruptive innovators. I can't remember the total title at this point, but I'll put the link below and let you know. But anyways, I learned by reading that book that my innate desire to question everything and ask a lot of questions was actually a skill of a disruptive innovator. Okay, so I learned by reading that wow, this is a skill. But I learned also that in the workforce, everyone didn't look at that as a skill. Some people looked at it as a weakness. So when I was asking questions, some people would give feedback to others and it would come back to me like, is she competent? Is she able to do this? Does she know what she's doing? But then I had one leader that was different. One leader that said to me, hey, you ask a lot of questions. I see you always writing things down. Why do you do that? And I'm like, because I like to, one, remember what I'm doing, and I'm having different thoughts in my mind that I may want to piggyback or bring up later, that I may want to put in a parking lot in my mind and talk to someone later on about it versus disrupting the entire meeting. So you will have people that will look at your vulnerability as if like, are they competent? But then you have others that see it and they question why you do it, and then they begin to see that it's actually a strength, whatever vulnerability you're sharing, and they'll come in and develop it. Because what that leader did for me was they actually like helped a lot in developing me and telling me, hey, go here, and hey, I want you to shadow this person, and what path do you want to take? I want to help you get there. So I'm telling you all of this. I know I gave you a lot, but I know it makes sense too. And I'm not going to edit this podcast at all. Like, we're just putting this up and letting y'all have it. We're just going to put this video out and that's going to be it. But I'm telling you all of this to say, don't pretend like you have it all together, because having it all together is a lie. Everybody at whatever place and station they are in their lives, even if their skill is at the top, even if they're at the top of their profession, their industry, everyone has something that they want to work on. So it's okay for you to feel like that too. And if you would just be vulnerable, if you would just put yourself out there and let people know that you don't have it all together, you would find that the people that have what you need would come in and help you, just like for me in my class. Now, I'm not saying that every time you open your mouth, you got to speak on something that you feel like is an inadequacy in you. But what I'm saying to you is that you need to posture yourself to learn. You need to posture yourself to get what you need from others. Okay. I hope that makes sense. I really super appreciate you all for listening to me. Again, I'm Lola with The Smoking Prophet. The Smoking Prophet is a life advice brand designed to resource you spiritually, creatively, and socially. Our goal is to give you what it takes others years to get, and we do that through a blog and through a podcast. So you can find our blog at thesmokingprophet.com and our podcast wherever you listen to podcasts. It's called The Smoking Prophet Podcast. Again, thanks for listening. Until next time, have the most amazing life. Bye! Spiritually, creatively, socially, spiritually, creatively, socially. Do life, do life, do it better, do it better. Do life, do life, do it better, do it better. The Smoking Prophet will inspire and equip you. The Smoking Prophet takes your skills and gifts and molds you.